grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Almighty God,
to you all our hearts are open, all desires are known, and from you we seek to pray. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him. speaking the truth in Christ. I'm not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all. God bless forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taking the five loaves and the two fish, he looked up to heaven something larger and more complex, and you'll be pleased or shocked to know that when people apply to be a priest, there's a lengthy psychological testing that goes on. I know many seem to slip through that net. I'm not sure how it happens, but nevertheless, it does exist. And then later on, as one progresses in one's vocation, or depending on the sector of ministry in which one finds oneself, there's always profiles. We're all going to do this test together to see what our profile is. And many of you, if you've been engaged in social work or psychology or teaching or any other kind of corporate place where they do a lot of group thing, will remember the huge popularity of Myers-Briggs test. Everybody took it. It was a Myers-Briggs. Yeah, see? And then you were an initial. You went from being, yes, I could be a good husband, to I am an ISTJ, I am an EXPN, I am an ABCD, whatever. Now, there's nothing about that that changed you in any way. It just told you what you were. And really, it becomes an excuse. And certainly the church, the Myers-Briggs test was huge. I seem to have lost my connectedness here. I'm not sure why. Is that better? Yes. And so when there might be a problem, say in a parish or within a working group, people would say, I can't help it. I'm an IPST. That's just how I am. So there was no real impetus, there's no impetus for change or no reason to change, because one was simply stuck in one's personality type. And within the College of Bishops, we did a thing called, Berkman. It's called Berkman. And this told you about what your working style was and what would happen if things were going, well, I'm not sure what's up with this. The microphone today is kind of going on and off. Is it on? It's on. It's off. Is it on? It's on. Yeah. It seemed to be acting up early this morning. So within this Berkman test, it told you what your working style was. It told you how things would do if you were doing it well. But then if you ran into any obstacles, it told you all the horrible things you would become or do if things didn't work out according to your working style. Sorry, I'm gone again. So I'm giving it up now. I'll just shout. I'm giving you. So the problem with these tests, all of them, is they transforming time in my life. The second time came many years later. In the last parish I was in, we had a Bible study. We used to meet every Wednesday night. It was usually just an excuse to eat off a lot of food, talk about what was happening in the Young and the Restless, talk about a few current events, and hopefully study the Bible. Now, one of my besetting Our response to God's presence with us in His Word is in our confession of faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed on page 189. Let us stand and confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
I believe
in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. Set free all who are bound by fear and despair. Lord,
hear our prayer. Grant a peaceful end and eternal rest to all who are dying, and your comfort to those who mourn.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites us to His table. Let us confess our sins confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God,
we confess that Jesus is God.
Eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus. offer you this day, and feed us continually with that bread which satisfies all hunger for your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Our Eucharistic prayer is prayer 2 on page 196. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
We give you thanks and praise Almighty God through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who place their hope in you. And so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death and banish the darkness of sin and despair. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and those you love, here and in paradise, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated, please. Does anyone have any announcements? Mr. Fowler.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Great announcement on the parish vision meeting in Hall this week, and accepted to organize the corn rolls, kick off the fall season. Jump up. We accept it or not, but you know what? When the hockey season starts, it's going to be a whole different ball game.
I don't think I have to keep repeating this flower announcement because we are absolutely bedazzled this morning by these beautiful flowers. Are they all from your garden?
No, just
these. Whose beautiful garden did the rest of these come from?
I'm guessing it's Anita.
Anita.
And field across the road.
And the field across the road. God is good. God does provide. You're stunning. Which leads me to my next announcement, which is, as you know, next Sunday, the 13th, we will not be having our regular service. We'll be meeting 2:30 at the old folks didn't hear this